I'm definitely a Galway girl. I sometimes lie and tell people Ed Sheeran wrote the song about me. And sometimes they believe me and then it gets really awkward.
I am from Galway, born and bred. I grew up on the outskirts of the city. When you're stood right on the coast in Galway, the next thing to the west is America. There's definitely the sense of possibility and open frontiers. I've always felt that from here. The city always sort of feels abuzz with creativity. You can't walk down, you know, Shap Street or Key Street without seeing lots and lots of musicians playing and things happening, and it's colourful and it just feels alive.
I'm so lucky my family are still here and around. When I come home now, I'm treated like a 17-year-old. You know, you're just their little sister or their daughter. You're not someone off the telly to them. This was when I graduated drama school and I was put on a ones to watch list, but I didn't do anything for several years after that. So you could be watching me, but I wasn't really achieving very much. This is the script for Jess and Joe Forever. I love this play so much. I have such a special memories of it because I signed with my agent from that play. And then my first audition with my agent was Derry Girls. And then Shondaland saw Derry Girls and called me in for Bridgerton. And then I got Bridgerton. So I remember finding out when Julie Andrews was cast, I just started crying. I just thought, this is crazy to me. Being in school plays, I would put in so much preparation and I'd draw pictures of what I thought the characters looked like and decide what clothes, kind of clothes they should wear, what accessory would they have and what would that mean and what does their voice sound like. This is the notebook that I made when I was auditioning for Derry Girls. Claire Devlin, 16, awkward, nerdy, wears a jacket over school uniform. And then it was the Troker box because she was on the fast for week mal. Jared Leto felt very important to have in there. These are the scripts for Derry Girls.
What's all this? I thought we were going to be individuals this year. Well, I'm not being an individual on my own. And then the thing with Claire is she's actually quite nervous, so everything kind of had to be quite fast when she talked, and she actually talks a million miles an hour, and then there's lots of stuff in there, there's lots of information to kind of get through.
But that was like all in the writing. It takes me ages to learn the scripts, and then they're embedded in my brain for the rest of my life. Kieran is like the big brother who'd be into all these cool movies. He got me into like Star Wars and how movies were made, and he bought me this little black and white video camera for Christmas. It just, in that box, was like a world of possibilities, what I could make, what I could do. It felt like magic.
Like, she had The Wizard of Oz when she was little on a VHS tape. That was a time when I was babysitting you, so you were really young then. She would literally watch The Wizard of Oz from start to finish, and then rewind the tape and start again. So good.
Describe her now or describe her growing up? It's actually pretty much the same.
It's the same, yeah.
She was never one of those kids that like would, you know, if people were here, jump out and perform. It was more kind of, she had her own idea about doing things always and very independent. You know, she didn't prefer to go to her room and create something and then maybe show it to me or Kieran or, yeah.
Well, I'm just really proud of you when you do good work. And I'm proud of you that you got the chance to do good work. And I'm just delighted for you, always.
Thanks, Kiki.
Always, yeah.
Yeah. So we are at School Wirra, which was my primary school. I haven't been back for a really long time. Really want to look at the tiny toilets. Is that weird? Oh no, they're normal sized toilets now. How are you?
You're back.
How are you? I don't know whether to call you Miss Carney or Adele.
Oh, no, you can call me Adele.
How are you? It's so nice to see you. I wish I could give you a hug.
I wish I could give you a hug. I'm so thrilled to
have
you here.
Oh my goodness.
This is where it all began,
yeah,
in this little cozy room. Oh God.
But I remember it so well. Like I can remember doing the mimes for the speech and drama exams.
Yes.
And I remember one of them was making a sandwich. It's funny the things you remember.
And then particularly she would skip into the drama class because she loved it. You know, she was absolutely hungry. This is, yeah, definitely where acting in front of an audience began, and it was playing, but playing for a purpose, and you could, you know,
yeah,
just try and be all these different people, and
yeah,
I just loved it so much. Yeah.
And now you're on our dream board,
and our vision board,
our students to aspire to.
You are such an inspiration to me, and you gave me such faith in myself, and I've been so privileged to have so many kind people behind me all this time, because I absolutely wouldn't be as lucky as I am now with my career if I hadn't had that. So just thank you so much.
I think I was really, really lucky because my best friend is the best friend I've had since I was 7 years old, Maeve, and we went to university together and studied the same thing. I think like having her by my side was just really special and wonderful.
2008, I'd say, was the last time we were here together. That was like our last year of our degree.
Yeah.
We've known each other a long time.
Yeah.
I can't shake her off.
I know, keep crawling back. That's everything to say about myself.
Yeah, we met when we were 7.
Yeah.
We met in school, Laura. Yeah. We made many videos together, yeah.
A lot. All under Nicola's direction.
I mean, yeah, my sister calls me Spielberg. And then I had a very uncompromising vision. And I was a bit more of an Orson Welles, and that I was just sort of a bit of a tyrant, I feel like.
No!
Like we did Spice Girls as well.
Yep.
And you were Baby Spice, I think.
I was Baby Spice and Sporty Spice, I think. You kind of.
And I was Posh, because she was my favourite.
The theatre that we would have done a lot of productions in.
Yeah.
And a lot of improv nights is tucked inside here. And I remember going up and visiting when you were filming the first series, and I met all of the Derry girls.
Yeah.
And for me, I was just so delighted that finally your talent was being recognised, and you were just on that cusp of something really life-changing.
One of the biggest parts of acting, it's just buying into the fantasy and sort of believing it, and believing you're in that world, and being able to suspend your own disbelief is a big thing too, and just totally give yourself over, and sort of a childlike sense of wonderment that you can't really lose. Coole Park, it's this beautiful woodland. It's very magical. When you come here as a kid, I think it looks like a place that lords and ladies would have been, and kings and queens and fairies and whatever. It just sets your imagination ablaze. You know, the stories that I've gotten to share, and things like Bridgerton, which are made with so much love and are so magical. And I think if I was a kid and I knew, if I could go back in time and say, you know, you do get to do it. This is what you get to do. I would just have been, blown away.